So what do you make of the news coverage of this?
Your viewers won't be shocked to hear this, Tucker, but the news media, the fake news media, are lying about the situation in Venezuela. Let me put it for you this way. Imagine if Hillary Clinton had refused to admit defeat after losing to President Trump in 2016 and banded together a group of 24 U.S. soldiers and attempted to take the White House by force. I don't think she'd be walking freely on the streets the way Juan Guaido is walking right now in Caracas. And I certainly think the news media would be calling it rightfully a coup. And let me just tell you, when it comes to what's happening on the ground there, I can tell you, I was there for a month earlier this year. The opposition has no popular support. Juan Guaido proved today once again that he will only ride in to power on the back of a U.S. tank. And what's more, we hear about a humanitarian crisis there, Tucker, but what we never hear is that is the intended result of U.S. sanctions, which have targeted Venezuela since 2015. Sanctions which, according to a report that was released just last week by the Center for Economic and Policy Research, has led to the deaths of 40,000 Venezuelans and will lead to the deaths of thousands more if these sanctions aren't overturned. President Trump, if he truly cared about the American or the Venezuelan people and the American people for that matter, he would end this disastrous policy, he would end the sanctions, and he would look into John Bolton's eyes, into Elliot Abrams' eyes, and Mike Pompeo's eyes and say, you are fired. You are leading me down a disastrous path, another war for oil, something the president said.
You are passionate.
He was celebrated by the American people when he said Iraq was a mistake, and now he's willing to do it again.